Recorded Books presents DJ Funkyfoot, Butler for Hire, by Tom Angleberger, illustrated by Heather Fox, read by Mark Turetsky. Opening. My phone rang. "Greetings," I said. "I am DJ Funkyfoot, and I am at your service." "Good," said a prickly voice. "I'm Cactus Kwame of Cactus Kwame's Roller Rink and Disco Rodeo. I need a DJ for our big Disco Rodeo Roller Boogie contest tonight." "Ah," I said, "I'm afraid you have made a common mistake, sir." "No way," said Cactus Kwame, and he was extra prickly. "I never make a mistake." "Yes, sir," I replied, even though I knew he had made a mistake. "I am a butler who serves tea, not a DJ who plays music." "So can you come over and play us some crazy disco beats tonight or not?" "I'm afraid not, sir," I said. "As I was trying to tell you, I am not a DJ." "Whoa, hold up. Aren't you DJ Funkyfoot?" "Yes, sir." "But you're telling me you're not a DJ?" "No, sir," I said. "Then why do you call yourself DJ Funkyfoot?" yelled Cactus Kwame. I did not yell back. I remained calm. I have had a lot of training to become a butler, and part of that training is not getting mad. "My parents named me DJ Funkyfoot because they hoped that I would someday become a hip-hop star." "Well," asked Cactus Kwame, "did you become a hip-hop star or not?" "No, sir," I said. "I became a butler."
"A butler?"
"Yes, sir."
"What does a butler do?"
"I do whatever my employer needs me to do," I said. "For example, I might prepare a cup of tea in the early evening."
"I don't want a cup of tea in the early evening," yelled Cactus Kwame. "I want crazy disco beats all night long."
"I don't do that."
"But it'll be on TV. I thought you hip-hop stars loved to be on TV."
"I'm not a hip-hop star. I'm a butler."
"Well, you must not be a very good one if you go around yelling at people like that."
He was right. I had forgotten my training. I wasn't being a good butler. "I am so sorry, sir," I said, but Cactus Kwame had hung up. Part 1. Butler for Hire. Chapter 1. My phone rang.
"Greetings," I said,
reminding myself to be polite no matter what the other person said.
"I am DJ Funkyfoot, and I am at your service."
"Great," said a stressed-out voice.
"We want to hire you."
"Very good, ma'am," I said. "But before you hire me, I must make sure you know that I am not a hip-hop star."
"Why would I want to hire a hip-hop star?" asked the stressed-out voice.
"I don't know, ma'am," I said. "But many people do, and..." The stressed-out voice interrupted me.
"I don't need to hire a hip-hop star. I need to hire a nanny."
"I'm sorry, ma'am, but I am not a nanny either."
"What are you?"
"A butler, ma'am."
"That's close enough," yelled the stressed-out voice. "We can't afford to be picky. Another nanny just quit on us. That makes 43, and you're the only nanny I can find."
I had to remember my politeness training. "Again, ma'am, I am a butler, not a nanny."
"Who cares? It's the same thing."
"Excuse me, ma'am, but a nanny and a butler are not the same thing. In fact, there are some very important differences to..." The stressed-out voice interrupted me again.
"I don't have time to quibble," yelled the stressed-out voice. "Get over to Murky Pond Park right now."
The stressed-out voice hung up. Chapter 2. I was happy. I was happy even though I had been yelled at and hung up on twice in one morning. I was happy because I was going to have a job again. I needed a job really bad. You see, I used to be the butler for a very rich poodle named Countess Zuzu Poodaloo. However, she invested all her money in a robot that made cookies. When the robot went crazy and destroyed the city, she lost all of her money. So, I lost my job.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.